Romeo! Wherefore art thou Romeo?
I'll tell you where. Right here today. William Shakespeare's tale of star-crossed lovers Romeo and Juliet is currently being performed and drawing raves at the Guthrie. This is only the third time in the Guthrie's long history that this iconic production has been staged. Artistic director Joseph Hodge is the director. He's also a veteran performer in this, too. We'll talk about that. We're delighted to welcome the show's stars with us today, Kate Eastman, who is playing Juliet, and Ryan James Hatanaka, who is playing Romeo. Welcome to both of you. Great to have you here.
Thank you very much.
Welcome to the Twin Cities, and welcome the first time at the Guthrie.
Yeah.
First time.
Yeah.
Talk about that. Tell us about it, Kate.
It's my first job out of grad school. So I actually found out that I got this job the afternoon that I graduated.
In this role.
Yeah, and it's a role I've wanted to play since I was 13. And it's completely top to bottom a dream come true.
Yeah. Ryan James, tell us about your reaction to all
this. I've been hearing about the Guthrie since I moved to New York. It's certainly one of our nation's gem theaters. And I think any theater actor would want to work here at some point in their career, if not multiple times, if they're lucky enough.
They're lucky.
And it's such a special experience, too, I'm told, by performers, because everything's from the ground up here. The beautiful sets, the whole production.
Just everyone top to bottom at the Guthrie. I mean, the people that they have working there, building the sets, designing the costumes. Joseph Hodge is our director and the artistic director of the theater, and he just runs such a great ship. He's a great leader.
And it's great to be directed by an actor.
Yeah,
exactly. Who gets it, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, that also helps you.
Very hands-on.
This has a traditional set, but it's been contemporized. Tell us about the story.
Well, the traditional set signifies the older generation, which is very much in power in this story. And then the contemporary costumes and the energy of the young people is a way to illustrate how this is a play that ennobles and takes seriously the feelings of teenagers. And their passions and their desires are what animates all of the action. And their inability to fulfill those desires has to do with the older generation being unwilling to change.
Let's talk about generational stuff, Ryan James.
Sure.
So for a traditionalist, a Shakespearean traditionalist, this will still appeal.
This will absolutely still appeal. The Guthrie does a great job at, I think, crafting something that appeals to a wide audience range. I mean, an older audience would love this. And I think it's a lot of fun for the performers to live in that teenage mindset as well and really jump in every night.
And contemporary music is a big
Well, it also, there's some older traditional vibe in the music too. It really meets and mashes up.
Yeah, Victor Zupay.
Well, clearly it looks like you're having a great time doing this.
Yeah.
Great fun.
Yeah.
You have a nice long run for people too.
We do.
Yeah. Also
to until October 28th.
You picked a wonderful time of year to be here.
Oh, it's a beautiful city.
Stage and
beautiful
just to get out here and enjoy our beautiful cities.
Yeah.
It's great. Well, congratulations. Thank you for being here today.
Thank
taking
you so
time
much.
Out
Thanks
for us.
For having
Let's
us.
Give you information at home, everybody. Romeo and Juliet being performed through October 28th. You can find additional information at care11.com. Look under the shows tab and the news at 4. We're going to be right back.